Hello, this is Alex, and welcome back to the Atuin server. Yes, we got a name now. As you saw in the dragon video, if you saw that one, that was a lot of fun, all of us being on here. excuse me, all of us being on here together. I had a little bit of an accident over here. I was working on this thing. You can see I've been building a little more. This is not done at all, but I was in here crafting something, and it was raining, and there was thunder, and lightning struck this building here. And because of the overhang up there, this building caught on fire. And I was in here, and I could see the fire through the window, so I tried to get around and put out the fire. But once the fire starts spreading, it's quite impossible to keep up with it. So this thing here began to catch on fire as well. So I focused on saving this building because I didn't want it also go up in flames. This one, the little house here, is gonna get taken down anyways. So it was still annoying, and it's the first time that ever happened to me. Usually when lightning strikes in the game, it's raining and the rain puts out the fire immediately. But because of that overhang, the rain couldn't actually get to this house, so it's just started burning. And you can see it just took out just what's underneath here. So I've talked to Pandy, and I think we're gonna turn off, whoops, fire spread on the server maybe, because most of us are building stuff out of wool or wood. Or you can imagine Reggie's dojo, if you haven't seen that. He's building a huge dojo out of wool and dark wood and yeah, general stuff that burns well. So I've never had that happen before. Oh well, I just wanted to show you that, the fire damage before I actually took down that house. Let's see what else. I haven't really done anything else here at my base, but we did go to the end and kill the dragon. So let's go there now because I've been working in the end a little bit, and yeah, I can show you what happened there since we were there for the dragon fight. Here we go. Yoink. Oh yeah. And also the witch hut. Let's get to that a little bit later. So the end portal is down here. I brought back some end stone and I covered the portal just so you know that you're actually going to the end once you go in here. Oh, there's some blocks missing. Okay. So I put up end stone all the way around it. Put up some half slabs up there, so it matches the one below. It's just a simple little covering up job here, so you can see where it's going. And we come in here, and I mined out below, so you can just walk underneath here and jump up, and you get into the end. This is where we took the picture. You've seen this platform I built before. All the way back there is where the dragon was killed. But since then, I have built these tracks. So if we go into the cart, I laid down these tracks as well. And I used a water bucket to go down here. And we're gonna go down to about Y5, I think. 6? Yes, no, 5. And this track will take us, I think it's 160 or 170 blocks away from the island. So we end up here, and this is where we're gonna build some kind of end farm. I just started out here. I built this, and give me that. Yoink. Put it over there. So this is the arrival track, and this is when you leave, the departure. Takes you back. So another one. If someone else is heading out here, you're not gonna bump into each other. How did you spawn there? I need to look into this lighting situation, I guess. And we can take down that thing. So this track takes you back here, and it ends right behind this post, and you hit this again, and it continues on. And it is stuck through the ground here. I measured out where I wanted to go, and it ends right here. Right by the exit portal. So over here is the one of the towers. We all chose a tower of the obsidian to build a house on top, just so, you know, build something out here as well. And I chose this one, and I put this sign on, but before that said A, L, E, and then X on this side. Just thought it fit nicely with the side of the tower, so I'm gonna take that down, but I just wanted to do something while we were waiting for the fireworks and so on. So let's head back. Yoink. Skip the cutscene. And it's still night. I'm on here with Seamus. I think he's mining or something. Oh, these are ready for harvest. Yoink. Thank you. There we go. And let's go to the witch farm. Nope, that's the other way. We can get out here. Okay. Do I have any? Yes, I do. Good. Oh, and check joined. Very nice. Okay. I'm gonna show you this from the outside first, because I actually did a lot of stuff here. I've been taking away some more land. That's my pet chicken up there. And look at this from the outside. I think it looks very nice. I need to redesign the witch hut there behind, which is just a box around. I need to give it some more room, because the more air spaces that are around, the better it's gonna be the spawning in there. So let's get in there. Oh, okay, I guess I hit one of the small holes there. Okay, so I redesigned this. The witches came up here before. I went down below and changed everything. I'm gonna wait until a few witches appear here, and then I'm gonna explain to you what I did. Okay, we got a few of them coming here. Hello, ladies. You're looking ugly as usual. Nice wart. Suits your big nose. Yoink. Hello. Okay. So this is what it looks like on the inside. I built this entire thing out of the cobblestone walls, which is why there's these small holes. I'm gonna put some more detail on it for sure, but oh wow, they're coming quick and fast now, that's great. In here is where they spawn. I didn't change anything in there. I got another wart farm over there. The portal comes out here, and I should put up a sign here telling people how to use it. So you just push this button, they fall down. You can see down there they died. Now water is gonna push all the items onto a block that's directly below this one. Another piston is gonna push up, so all the items come up here. Yoink. And we can put them in here like that. So the farm is very good for getting potion ingredients. So for instance, I was actually breeding or making some of these potions while I was waiting here, which is also why I made this potion setup. Water bottles and yes. Hello. Did one of them survive down there? I don't know. You can't be too quick with this thing, because if there's water down there when they fall down, the witches will survive. And that is not the plan. Okay, let's go take a look. So this, the way I hooked it up, this is my access hatch here. Up here on that thing is the button, and the button, oh, come on. Okay, the button is hooked up, so when you press it, the block up there gets pulled down and to the side. This block that they'll stand on. Let's just let this lady come through. Come on. Oh, you got a sister? Oh, she's just as ugly as you. Okay. This is beginning to work well after we cleared up some more space and lit up some caves. So this block here gets pulled down and then to the side. So maybe we can see that from over here. Hit the button actually. Yeah? That happens first. And then after that's that line there that goes to that piston setup that pulls the pistons down into the side. The signal also comes here and with a little bit of delay gets put into this RS knowledge and pulse lengthener. When the signal reaches here, it immediately gets sent down there and opens the water gate. And then this thing keeps the signal on for about 3 or 4 seconds or something, and then stops the signal when we get down here. So the signal comes here with a delay, and this signal is on for 4 seconds. So when it comes down here, this immediately opens and sends the water down this passageway here. There's a delay here so that this piston will close the water in here. This stays open all the time. There's a piston back there, you can't tell which one it is, but it pushes out and shuts off the water. So all the items are now on that block in there at the very end. And then after a little while, there's a piston down here that then pushes up, so send all the items up to the arrival platform up there, I guess you can call it. And this thing here is just to send the signal down. I did this all once, but I wasn't happy about the positioning of the things, so I changed it all. I rebuilt it all. I started on a live stream, but I finished afterwards. So down here I got this mushroom farm, because a lot of the potions actually need the mushrooms to make the fermented spider eyes, so I just set up a small farm down here. We might as well use the space underneath. There we go. So that's what this room is for. Okay, let's get out of here. Right. Close the hatch. And we got some goodies here. Bye bye. So you see, after a little while, the water comes, pushes in, and there's a piston there closing, and another one pushing up to send all the items up here. It's a pretty good setup. I'm very happy about this, the way it turned out. And once we get it all lit up here and all the caves and so on, this is going to be a very good place to get glowstone, redstone, and gunpowder. Okay. Okay, so this house has got to go. I was spending a little time out at the witch's hut there, making some potions, and there was no reason for you to watch me do that. Let's get this down here so we can actually pick up the glass again. Oh, and I wanna I shouldn't actually use this, but yeah, I'm just gonna tear this down. I need to repair the other building. That thing got all caught in the fire, as I said. So let's just get this guy out of here. I wanted to tear this down anyways. So this, it, well, it didn't turn out well because it's never fun when you have to watch, stand back and watch your stuff burn and you can't do anything about it. So yeah, let's get rid of this guy. Yes, very good. Pick up all of the stuffs. There, and more and more. Nope. Put down a few torches. There, there. Oh, we got a trapdoor there. Okay. I think I got my building materials in here. What is this? Oak wood. That is not what I'm gonna use. Put the door. No, actually, I think I have a door chest here. Yes, let's get rid of that. The oak wood goes up here. Put some spruce back. And we need the dark wood here. Okay. Let's fix this guy. I think it goes like. Yes, and then there. And there. And there. Repair. Yes, we need to repair this guy. Is that? No. We got another one there. I think that's good on the inside. Let's check out here. Yes, I'm thinking about maybe making cobblestone the bottom block and all the way down out here, so it's like a foundation of sorts. I think this looks weird, maybe. I don't know. Jump, get up here. I think it's all as it should be now. I don't know why these are here. Yes, very good. Let's get rid of the knight. Aim was on while I was out at the witch hut there, so I'm gonna get rid of this again like that. Get rid of these guys. Nope. Yeah, we could just put it in here. I can sort this out later. Oh, hello. There's Sippy here paying me a visit. Okay. What I wanted to do was maybe get the ant farm started. So let me gather some redstone stuff and we can go out there and maybe create the first layer. Do you think I need more sheep? I'm gonna need some more redstone for this. So while I mine this, I just wanted to talk to you about my Let's Play Series 3. People keep asking me when I'm gonna play that again, and I don't know if I'm ever gonna play it again. I'm thinking about maybe ending that series because I really prefer playing on this server now, and unless I get massive feedback on don't end the Let's Play 3 series, I think that's what I'm gonna do because I feel like more playing on this server, if that makes any sense. I just have more fun here. There's the guys are here, and yeah, it's more fun to me, you know? And get out of here. So I just wanted to tell you that I will of course make an end episode from that, but I don't think I'm gonna get back to it. Oh, you see this guy is looking at the floor all the time? This is why. Look down here. All of my villagers found their way into this house and down the ladder. One of them, two of them actually, has found their way inside the enchantment table, which means that I can't actually use the enchantment table anymore. Yeah, okay. So, Yeah. Let me know what you think about me ending the Let's Play 3 series. I know some people like watching that. I know some people don't care what I play as long as it's Minecraft. I like this, as I said, more. So please leave a comment telling me what you think so I can make a decision on what to do. And if I end the Let's Play 3 series, I will of course put up the world for download, and you get to derp around on it if you so desire. Okay, more redstone. I got to level 15 from mining that redstone, so I want to put actually enchanted book efficiency 4 on my shears. When I finally got the silk touch, excuse me, I put it on these shears here. And yeah, I want to put actually another one of these efficiency 4 books on here. So let's see what that's gonna cost me. 13. Okay, efficiency 5. That's gonna be very nice. And then I'm gonna rename it. But I don't want to carry that around. Yes, let's mine some more redstone. Yay, level 18. Guess we can do this now. Oh yeah. Okay, so what's it gonna cost to rename? 39? Wow. Okay. That's a project, I guess. 39? Wow. I'm out at the end now. Just getting ready to build maybe the first layer of this ender farm. I just measuring out here. So this is the middle of the platform. I guess, yeah, let's just make it 17 wide, I guess. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And over here, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. I think it would be nice if they fell down and landed on these. And you could just walk around here and hitting their feet. So that's what I'm gonna try and do. Now I need to go up. I need some more stuffs. I brought some more stuff out here. Redstone, pressure plate, all that. Goody. I made some ladders. And we need to go up from this level, which is 7. And we need to go up 43, so that's an even 50. That's nice. So at 50 is where the bottom of the jungle, no, the, what's it called? Oh, I forget. I'm just gonna do it here. So 43. I'm just gonna do it like this. I need the, what are they called? I can't remember. So they don't fall and hurt themselves too much and die. The vines with the buttons underneath. So let's see what happens up here. So this should be 49. Yes, very good. Good. So 50, and we go around because that is there. So we need 2 and 1 more. I don't need that on there anymore. And then, excuse me, I forgot to count. Dang it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. What's the length, I think? And let's see if I look straight down. I can't actually see what I'm looking at. So it's 17. Then these edge around here. I think this is right. I hope so. And I'm out of cobble. Very nicely planned. Feather falling, yes. Okay. We need the ladders to get down. We. No, actually. Oh, wow. That was close. That could have been very bad. Okay, get some more of this. Actually, I need some more. Well, I'm just gonna build some of this, and I'll get back to you once I had a little more built. Oh, I need to eat. Oh my. Look at all these guys up there. Maybe this guy has. Oh, he. How come? Maybe he teleported down here. You can see them. Oh, that's my phone here. Hang on. Okay, sorry about that. They're falling down. Give me my torch. And dying. So this saw is. Ooh. already working as a farm for ender pearls, I guess. But I just put up three layers. Now I made some buttons. But I am going back to see if I can find some vines back there. I just put up these. Arrival and departure. Let's depart. Whee! And arrival. Hooray! Okay, mission successful. I brought some vines. Let's get the buttons. Let's see, we need some more blocks. We need some of these. Yeah, I forget. Let's see if I actually remember how to do this. I want to start with putting up the vines and the buttons. And now I gotta fight all of these guys up here. Oh well. Let's see how it goes. I think I'm just gonna push them off for now. So, just hold down shift. You can push them off the edge. Bye bye. Oh, he got mad. Okay. But this is more than 43 blocks, so. You need to make them drop 43 blocks to be a one-hit kill. So, okay, we got one more guy here. Bye bye. Okay, so buttons on the bottom row, like this, and the same on the other side. And then up here, we put the vines. Okay. And the. Whoa. Oh, the vines saved me. The same over here. Yes. I'm gonna finish this. Then we put the torches here on the outside. And on top of those, we put a block. You may remember me building this in the LP world, so I'm not gonna go in too deep detail here. And we put redstone torches on top here. There, yes. And now we're done with those, and now we need these. So this is can be a little bit tricky. I need to actually hit the top of. No, how is it? Do I need to? I forget. The pressure plate. Let's see. That's gonna light that. Which is gonna. Yeah, this should be up here. So I need to. Let's just put it that. I know that's wrong, but. There. Okay. Yes, that's right. So. There, and now if I put a pressure plate here, yes, it's gonna push the Enderman out. And since he's three high, it's not gonna push me, but it will push him out. So I'm gonna finish this both sides. Okay, that's done. Now I put the half slabs here on the end. One of the good things about this design, in my opinion, is that You don't use too many resources. You don't need to know anything about redstone. You got a torch on the outside there. You saw I placed underneath that, and a torch and buff, and then the piston, and two rows of vines here. They haven't grown all of them, so some of them are gonna die, but that's okay. I can live with that. And you don't have to spawn proof this because this is considered a translucent block. So Enderman cannot spawn on top of this. So as long as the top block is a oh, that was actually yeah. Got this problem. Well, it's not a problem, but as long as this block, the piston is the top block, then Enderman can only spawn on these spawn pads here. And then we just put down the pressure plates. And get out of here. Okay. And there. And that should do it. Let's see what happens. I haven't tested this. You just saw me finish building it. Okay. Most of them are gonna die here in the beginning because the vines haven't grown too long. One too long, I mean. So they're gonna fall. They should spawn more often. You can see the redstone torches up there, they're gonna blink whenever someone spawns on it. There we got one. He died. Okay, I'm gonna keep an eye on this for a little while. Okay, it's beginning to work. I actually want to turn down my sound because, yes, you know these guys are pretty loud. I want to try a little bit of a different design here. See if it works. I put down the half slabs and I removed the blocks underneath here. The Enderman has still one hit kill, as you can see, but the XP can actually find its way to you when you're walking around here. That's a problem with the old design, I think, is that the XP can pile up on the other side if you're running back and forth on one side. So I wanted to see if I could make this work. I still need to make all of the I need to make the rings all the way down so the Enderman can only fall in here and not out here by accident if they walk off sideways or somewhere or something. But it is working. They're spawning up there. As you can see, I've gotten a lot of Ender pearls already. Hello, guy. So, I just need to make some more layers, and we are gonna be set for Ender pearls and XP again, which is good. So I'm actually gonna end this episode here. Remember to leave your thoughts on whether or not I should continue the Let's Play Series 3. I haven't felt like playing on it for a while, as I said, so I think I'm gonna end it, but I would like to hear your thoughts on it. So, okay, thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.